All right, welcome back. And in this video, we'll be going through how to actually set up a wallet for Cardano on the Yoroi wallet. And I'll be transferring some ADA from my Bittrex account to my new Yoroi wallet, and then showing you how to actually delegate that to the stake pool. So a couple of steps here. It should take about 15 minutes. But from start to end, you'll know how to transfer some ADA from your exchange, where hopefully you've already purchased some ADA, and start delegating it to earn some rewards. And I'll take you through all the steps one by one. Now, you can get to the full tutorial on our website. If you just go to the bottom down here where it says Get Started, you can click on the link here to learn more, and that will take you to the full tutorial on what to do. So if you miss anything, you can come back to this tutorial and it will just take you through each one of the steps. All right, so let's get to it. First off, go to the yoroi-wallet.com website. Make sure you go into the right one. It helps sometimes to actually Google it. So let's go to google.com. Yoroi wallet. And there it is there. So usually Google would not push a fake a website to the top of the search listing results. So I'm trusting this one here. And if you go from other sources as well, you'll be able to see that this domain is correct one. So just be wary of that, because you could be possibly downloading an incorrect version that's been made by a hacker to steal your ADA. So just be aware of that. Something to keep in mind. All right, now that we're here, I'll just close some tabs. Really hate these tabs. Click on download and then download for Chrome or whatever browser you're using. In this case, I'm using Brave, the privacy browser based on Chrome, but it uses the Chrome engine. So when I download it, I can just click on Chrome here and that will start the installation process. Now, Yoroi is a browser-based wallet which connects to a remote host. So what that means is it runs locally on your computer, and it connects to a cloud-based version of the mainnet, the blockchain. So you don't need to download a copy of it yourself locally. The other alternative wallet that you could use, let me scroll to the bottom down here, is Daedalus. And that wallet downloads a copy of the blockchain to your computer. So it works in a different way. It takes a little bit longer to download and get started with Daedalus. That's why I tend to recommend Yoroi as a starting wallet, just to get up and running a little bit faster. You can use both, and I do use both. I like to use a Daedalus wallet and then load it into Yoroi. It works pretty much the same way. But I digress. Let's go back to here and download this for Chrome. Yes, I've clicked that. This will come up. Comes up in the web store. There's a couple of things that you can check here. You can check the ratings. Lots of high ratings. Cool. It looks authentic. And 100,000 plus users have installed this. And I am on chrome.google.com. Great web store. Cool. I'm in the right place. Let's click Add to Brave. Yes, add that. Does its little checks, downloads it, and installs it to my Chrome extensions or Brave extensions. All right, now it's a little bit hidden under here. You can see all the stuff I've installed. I'll just click on Yoroi. Great. So that's loaded up the extension locally. So I'll just follow these steps. Again, these are all on the website here. Let's go back to it so we've got a reference. It takes you through each one of the steps, but let's continue here. Let's go English. Just good to keep note of that. Nothing is tracked, etc., etc. Let's go agree, continue. Now, for the sake of this tutorial, I'll just choose simple. We won't go into anything too complex. We just want to get started. Now, you can skip this for now. It's not too important, but it just enables like special URLs and links so that you can get paid into your Cardano wallets without giving them long wallet addresses. I'm just going to allow it. Yeah, sure. Finish. Cool. So that's the initial setup done. Now, if you have a hardware wallet like a Trezor or a Ledger, I've got a Ledger, and maybe I'll do a video in the future on how to connect the Ledger wallet up. But here, let's go and create a wallet directly on here. So click on create wallet. Now we've got some options here, and the Cardano is the one that we want to use. And we want to create a wallet. Let's give this wallet a name. My new wallet. It's not too important. Sending password, I'll create something a little unique. Now, if you have a password manager, something like LastPass is a good password manager. I use one called 1Password. 1Password, it's fantastic. It does cost some money. LastPass is a free one that you can use, but is very secure as well. For the sake of this tutorial, I will just use a password generator website. Ah, look at that. Brave gave me a password that I can use. And you can all see my password. That's all right. I'll be deleting this password and moving funds right after. At least 10 characters. Great. Okay, let's go back here. 8 characters. Let's go here. In saying that, I probably will blank out a lot of these screens so you don't see them. Okay, let's paste in my password here. Doesn't match. Great, there we go. It's all good. Create the wallet. Now, the next step is the password recovery phrase. Now, this phrase is unique to your wallet and is used anytime you want to restore the wallet on a new computer. If I delete the extension from my browser here, the wallet will be gone. And the only way to get the funds back is with that this particular recovery phrase. So if you lose this, you're pretty much locked out of your wallet. So don't lose this. It's a good idea to perhaps write it down on a piece of paper, laminate that piece of paper, and store it somewhere where it will be completely safe, where it won't burn, fireproof safes, bury it somewhere, I don't know. Whatever you can think of to keep that piece of paper safe. I've seen some people etch the words into leather by leather pressing, or etching it into steel plates. So there's different ways to keep that recovery phrase safe, and you know, there's a couple of ideas. So let me just go continue here. So I've gone through the recovery phrase portion of the wallet creation. So it gave me a whole list of words that I had to write down and store, and I've written them down on a piece of paper, which isn't the most secure at the moment, but you know, at least they're not stored on my computer. From there, I had to go through a check process. All those words were shown to me on the screen, and had to click on the particular words in the order that were required to show that I've got to the recovery phrase. And now I'll just go through the next step here and click on these two check boxes to confirm that I understand the implications of that recovery phrase. So just click on confirm. And that's it. My wallet is successfully created. I have absolutely no ADA in here, and I won't be able to delegate until I actually transfer some funds into it. So this is the fun bit. So let's go and click on receive. So here I've now been given my address, which I can copy. So I've copied that. I can generate a new address. So if you want to keep your fund transfers private, this wallet can actually store multiple addresses, and I can generate as many addresses as I want. That way I can transfer large amounts of money into one address and then into another address, transfer different amounts. So people can't see that I'm transferring large amounts of ADA into a single address, and it's a little bit harder to track. Still trackable, but it's a little bit harder. So now I've got that address copied. I will go to my exchange, which is Bittrex here. Now I've clicked on holdings, and you can see all of the crypto that I hold, which is a whole lot of nothing. You can see that I'm a really bad trader, and I've purchased some terrible things. ADA is probably the only good thing I've got here. Verge, which I've purchased years and years ago, maybe about 2 years ago. Bought quite a lot of it, and it's worth almost nothing now. Fantastic. I'm sure many others have done that. But that goes to show that I'm a terrible trader, and staking is probably my best bet in regards to investing or playing in the crypto markets. So I've clicked on ADA here. I can see my balance. Click on withdraw here. Now I've got my address. I'll just paste it in here. Now I'll just check some of these characters. I know it starts with address, so I know I'm sending it to a Cardano address. The prefix is nice. There's different types of addresses, like a stake address and stuff. So having this little bit at the beginning here lets me know that I'm actually putting in the right type of address into the field here. So the last few characters here, I'll just check TD8C. So where did my wallet go? TD8C. Okay, cool. I've copied the complete string, so that's good. So let's go back to my wallet. Nope, holding. Here we go. Amount to withdraw. Let's withdraw everything. I just clicked on that there. Great. Now there's a withdrawal fee. Bittrex is so far the lowest withdrawal fee that I've found. There may be lower, but they only charge you one ADA to withdraw the withdraw your balance. So I've got 62.5 ADA left. So let's withdraw that. I need my two-factor authentication code. There we go. Let's withdraw. There we go. Withdrawal submitted. Thank you. Now, my tutorial that I wrote for this doesn't go through the withdrawal and depositing into your Yoroi wallet. I kind of skim over that phase. I do talk about it, but I don't go into detail with it because I had to take screenshots of certain exchanges and stuff. So I didn't really want to do that through the tutorial, but you could see through the video basically how it's done. Now we're up to the staking part, as long as this goes through. So let's go to the wallet now. I've got the confirmation from the exchange, and there it is there. Suddenly, magically appears. Fantastic. Now I can click on delegation list on the right here, and I can search for the pool, ADAOZ. Oh, before I go to that, this screen here shows you a list of a whole bunch of pools ordered by the scoring system provided by ADA Pools. I can go all through the, here we go, adapools.org. You can use that website to check and have a look at all the different pools and all the information about them. But if you want to support our channel and our pool, type in ADAOZ, do the little search. That's us there. That's our icon. It may change to an OZ to reflect the ADAOZ name. And you can see all of our social channels here, etc., etc. And then just on the right of the screen here, we click on delegate. And we are done. Now you can see here there is a bit of a fee, a 2.17 fee. So we're down to 60 ADA after transferring from the exchange. We had like a 64, I think. We took a fee and then another fee here to delegate to a stake pool. So I'll just grab my sending password. There we go. And we can delegate. Gives you approximation. You could see from that previous screen the approximation of how much ADA I will receive. And it's roughly 5% per annum through the lifetime of the staking. So there we go. It was successfully delegated the ADA to the wallet, which is what we wanted. Let's go back to the dashboard and we'll be able to see some information in regards to our delegation. All right, so now I've delegated my ADA to the pool, and I can see a little error here in the upcoming rewards area. So I can see I've delegated to the pool here. There's the details of the pool. That's fantastic. But here it says staking key isn't registered, so you won't get your rewards. Now that's the staking key of this particular wallet, and it may be because I have just created the wallet and the stake key and the address hasn't quite registered on the blockchain yet. But a simple refresh of this after a while should clear that up. So let's just refresh that. It's been a good 10 minutes or so. Oh, there we go. And that error is gone now. So first reward is slower. Okay, that's fair enough. First reward is slower. But you can see here now that I've delegated to the ADAOZ pool, which is fantastic. Now, I've delegated in this epoch here, which is in epoch is 5 days in regards to Cardano timing. So I've delegated in this epoch, and in the next epoch, 257, is when the rewards from the previous epoch are calculated, and the rewards from epoch 257 actually won't get distributed to until epoch 258. So they get delegated at this point, calculated at this point, and then rewarded at this point. So it takes 10 days for the ADA to actually eventually get to my wallet in return. But you know, if my ADA is still in there in the next epoch, then in 257, then in 259 is when I will get rewarded at the end there. Now, if you saw in the screens before, the estimated return on ADA at the moment is, I think it was 0.4 ADA, so it's not much. So it's quite low, but you know, it's I'm only delegating 60 ADA here. Now, if I was to move my ADA around to pool to from one pool to another, I will incur that 2.1 transfer fee each time I move. So I will actually lose a lot more moving from pool to pool. So it's kind of important to choose a pool and stick with it for a while, at least until you get your rewards, which hopefully are higher than your transfer fees from going from pool to pool if you're re-delegating over and over again. But that's basically it. You've delegated now, and now it's just a waiting game for the pool to actually produce blocks and send you the rewards. So it's a matter of time, but over a year you will get your 5 to 6% return on your ADA. That's how the proof of stake protocol works. So it's just a matter of sitting back, pouring yourself a glass of something nice, and waiting until that gets rewarded to your wallet. Just a waiting game. Now, that's all compounding and continuously increasing your stake. So just sit back and enjoy the rewards. This is especially good for people that are bad at trading, such as myself, or don't have the time for it, and I clearly don't. So hopefully you found this video useful in regards to going through the entire process. Like I said, you can go to the cardano.com.au website and go through all the steps there to follow and see exactly how to go through that staking process. If you found it useful and you want to help with the pool and the channel, hit that like and subscribe button on the channel, or even better, you could delegate to us, search for us. The pool ticker is ADAOZ on Daedalus or Yoroi or ADA Lite wallets, and you can get staking straight away. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.